Hi there. Welcome to Best of Friends, where I'm just about to play a practical joke on Rani before we get started. Check this out. Ready? It's going to be so funny. Okay, shh, nice and quiet. What was that?
Did I scare you?
Yes!
It's the only thing best friends do to each other. Look! Oh. Abs?
My best friend because he's always there to play with.
Katie's a really good friend to have because she lets you come and play the games with her.
Morgan's my best friend because he's always a cheery person to have in the group.
Gita is one of my best friends because she's the funky clown of the group and she's always naturally kind.
Sophie's my best friend because she's generous and very nice and she cares about me.
Hi guys.
Hi.
Welcome to Best of Friends.
So, Morgan, how well do you know each other?
I think we know each other very well, and at the best of the group, I think it's Jordan.
Ooh. Best at what? What is he the best at?
I think he's the best at taking lead at things.
Jordan's the kind of leader of the group. Jordan, would you say that was fair?
Yeah, it's true.
Would you say if we had some really bad tasks for you, you'd take the lead in this then?
I'll try.
You'll try your best. Now, Cheetah, we'd like to get to know a little bit more about you and all your friends. So, does any of them have any special qualities you want to tell us about?
Yeah, Morgan's quite brainy.
Okay.
In here.
Pointing where his brain is.
You'll lose some brain cells if you do that.
Jordan's quite sporty. He's quite fast at running.
Everyone's giving us examples here. Brainy, sporty.
Katie's quite cheery. She's always, like, in a laughing mood.
You seem like you've got a big smile.
What about Sophie?
Sophie's like, she brings a really comforting thing to the group because she's always there for you, like, when you're sad or anything.
A nice vibe.
And what about you, Cheeto? What special qualities do you have as a friend?
I'm the clown.
You're the clown.
The funky clown.
The funky clown. What? Is this the funky clown dance? Is that what you do to entertain everyone? Now, guys, do you recognise the sound? It's a surprise twist and we could be changing things a little bit later on. And it could happen during a task, it could happen during a treat. So all you got to do is keep your ears open for it.
Are you ready to get on and find out who's doing the first task and the first treat then?
Yeah.
Let's bring in your unlucky dip. Now there's 5 sweets in this bag. 3 sweets will turn your tongues blue. Those people will be going off to do the first task. If your tongue remains clear, you get the first treat. All right, then, you got your sweets. Now it's time to say, you suck!
So who's doing the first task? Who's doing the first treat? Let's see those tongues. Take a look at each other.
You got a sweet tongue. So does Jordan.
Well done, guys. You know what you're doing. Who's coming along with you, though? Do you want to find out?
Not really.
OK, should we just leave?
Yeah.
All right, then. See you later. Bye.
Yeah. Let's find out. Here's the unlucky dip.
It just appears, doesn't it?
Right, we've got our sweets. What do we do now?
You suck!
I think they've been practicing. You ready? You want to see our tongues? Here we go. 1, 2, 3. I recognise that laugh.
And it means you have the task. It is the best of friends language.
Love it.
All right, then. Well, you know what you're doing. They know what they're doing. I know what I'm doing. Let's have a circle of friendship before we all leave.
We all know what we're doing.
We all know what we're doing.
Come on, let's get in there. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.
We are the best of friends because we're cool. The important thing is that we rule.
Yeah!
All right. It's called sweet corn transfer. Nimble and fast fingers are what you'll need to pass this first task. Using only toothpicks, you must each transfer 50 bits of sweet corn in 3 minutes to pass the task. How do you feel, Sophie?
Weird.
What about you, Katie?
How?
Do you think you need help?
Yes.
You know how small toothpicks are, though? They'll be about that big.
Yeah.
And sweet corn's even smaller. You're going to have to stab it in like that.
Yeah.
Pull out the sweet corn. It's 50 bits each.
All of that would be 150.
Yes, it would. Clever. I like your style. Let's go and take on this task. Go on.
Here we go, then. For your first treat, you are going on a Formula One racing simulator.
Cool!
You will experience the speed and adrenaline of racing at hundreds of miles an hour.
100?
Cool. And the best thing is, you can even race each other.
Yay! Yay!
Who's going to be the fastest out of you two?
Me! I'm going to be the fastest. You're going to lose.
You know what, guys? I think I'm going to be the fastest. See you later!
OK, then, Taskers, have you got your toothpicks in your hands there?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Now, the sweet corn is on this plate in front of you. Oh, nice sweet corn. And there's some. Have a little sniff. It's not bad, is it? Now, your task is to get the sweet corn from that plate, put them into your bowls, and you'll need to get 50 bits of sweet corn each. And remember, if one of you fails the task, you all fail the task. OK?
Yeah.
Your 3 minutes is on the clock, and it starts now.
When Abs put the sweet corn under my nose, it smelt horrible. I don't like sweet corn anyway.
Try not to rush it. Katie, that's perfect, perfect. The best way is just to get it up against the edge of the plate and just stab it in. Got a good technique going now here, Katie.
Come on, you lot, we can try and pass this.
Well then, guys, take your car. Are we ready? All right, then, let's hit the lights and burn some rubber.
I felt really glad that I didn't get a blue tank because I wanted to get a treat and my game plan is to do the last task.
Oh!
How you doing, guys?
This is wicked.
We've had a minute, so you've got 2 minutes left.
The hard thing about the task was that it was really hard to pick up the pieces of sweet corn because when you done it off, they sometimes just slipped away from you and you had to try and do it again and again.
Morgan, you just passed me.
Yes, easy. I'm going to bomb foils.
Guys, that's it. Race is up. Let's find out how we did. Now, this is a computer readout. So you can see the second place would be Cheeto. You managed only 3 laps. But Morgan, you little speed demon, 7 laps you managed in that time. So you have come first.
10 seconds left. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Stop there. Put your toothpicks down.
What about that one?
You can count him. In you go. Let's see how you've done. Now, bear with us. This might take some time. Or will it? Here we go. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45.
Oh.
The target was 50. And if we have a look at your bowl, Sophie, and here, both bowls clearly haven't made the target either. So, all in all, guys, that's a fail, I'm afraid.
Nice to have you back all together. Now, you two look quite happy.
Oh, don't rub it in. What did you get up to on your treat?
Well, we done Formula Racing Driving.
Formula Racing Driving?
Yeah,
is that like Formula One Racing Driving?
Yeah, but virtual.
So it's not real? You didn't get to go into a Formula One car?
No.
So then, Cheeto, who was the fastest?
Morgan was the fastest,
yeah.
And then I was the second fastest. Rani was dead last.
Rani, OK. Just wanted to make that clear for everyone.
Yeah, thank you. So then, Taskers, what did you have to do for your first task?
We had to get some 2 toothpicks and we had to spike sweet corn onto the toothpicks and we had to put them into a bowl in 3 minutes and we had to get 50 of them.
50 in 3 minutes? Sounds pretty tough, doesn't it?
Mm.
OK, then, big question. Did you pass or did you fail? Well, not to worry, guys, it was, of course, only your first task, but that, of course, is the easiest task, and they only get harder now.
Now, what that means is that we still need 3 of you to go on and do the next task. So 3 of you can volunteer if you'd like to, or we can select 3 of you by using the unlucky dip.
So, guys, we need you to chat about it, because, of course, you've only done a treat so far, but you still need one of them to join you if you want to volunteer. So take a few moments to yourselves. We'll leave you to it. Come on, Abs, get out of the way.
I think us two should do. Should volunteer, yeah. and then you three do the unlucky dip.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Are you sorted? Finished chatting?
Yeah.
Got enough time for you? Come on, slow coach.
Yeah, I was just practicing my drive. And again, you see.
Oh, no, not again. Beep, beep. Everyone look out.
Right then, second task. Morgan, why didn't you tell us? What are you going to do for it?
Well, me and Cheeto are going to do the task, but now them three are going to do the unlucky dip.
OK, then, you two are doing the task, but who's going to go along with you?
Let's bring in your unlucky dip. So just three sweets in there this time. You guys can stay and watch. But who's going to get the blue tongue? There's just one blue sweet in there. Shut your eyes, please. And pick your sweets. We'll let the ladies go first. That means you're just left with whatever at the end now, I'm afraid. But you have all got three sweets. And there's something we'd like to add, a personal note.
You suck!
So let's find out which one of you is going to be going on the task. Guys, let's see those tongues. Okay, so you look happy. You pleased about that? You all right with that, Jordan?
Yeah, fine.
Well, let's see who's going to be joining you taskers and treaters. Let's bring in our unlucky dip.
I've got one.
Okay, we've got a sweet. What do we do now?
You suck!
Did they just say you suck?
I think they were talking to you.
No, you.
Okay, it's tongue time. Let's see who's doing what. One, two, three.
Oh, fingers coming my way. Jordan, Cheeto, Morgan, we're off to the second task. You up for this?
Yeah.
Good luck in that second task. Before that, let's have a second circle of friendship. In we get. One, two, three.
We are the best of friends because we're cool. The important thing is that we rule.
Yeah!
Let's find out what it is then. Face painting. Palettes at the ready. For this task, you'll be painting faces, that is. You'll be taught how to face paint by our expert. At the end of the demonstration, you'll have 6 minutes in which you'll each have to paint half of your teammate's face. How does that sound?
Wicked.
Okay. But what are we going to paint it as?
You know what? I haven't got a clue. Let's go and ask our expert. She's just over there. Come on, guys.
Okay, you ready for a treat?
Yeah.
Let's find out what you're doing. Okay, this says it's time to hit the beat. Because for your second treat, you're off to have your very own drum tutorial. You'll be able to bash around on the drums while also being taught by a percussion professional. Sound good?
Yeah.
Ready to hit the drums? Yeah. Nice and loud. Do you like loud noises?
No.
But we're gonna make some loud noise. Come on, follow me.
So then, taskers, this is Jo. She's our face painting expert. Hiya, Jo.
Hi, Ronnie. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Now, Jo, can you talk us through what are we gonna be doing for today's task?
Today, we are turning you into a spotty dog, Rani.
Turn me into a spotty dog? No one mentioned that. It's their task.
I know, but we need you as a demonstration model so they can do their task.
OK, to help these guys, I'm willing to do it. So, do I need to sit on the hot seat?
Yes, please. And if you can sort your hair out, that'd be lovely. Just make a line all the way round. Can you see how I'm doing that? OK. So you just work it nice and gently, and you can see I'm just doing gentle little strokes. I'm going to do the tongue next, okay? Coming round. So I'm just using that big fat brush. I'm going to give you a doggy nose. I'm going to do a little bit on here, like that. Okay, and then I want to see at least 5 dots on your face. I'm going to do 1, 2.
That was a big one. Are we all done?
We're all done.
Perfect, Jo. So half a face each. That leaves one person out. Who is going to have their face painted? Yay, Jordan. Right then, taskers, your 6 minutes start now.
I felt really sorry for Jordan because he had to do the task again and, like, he had just came from doing another task.
Hi there, Kevin. How are you doing? That sounded great. I've got the girls here. These are our treaters, Sophie and Katie.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
What have you got in store for us?
Today, we're going to give you a drum lesson.
Sounded good. You up for it, girls?
Yeah.
Right, let's do it.
Cool. So the first thing we're going to try is something called a single stroke roll.
When Jordan and Cheeto find out what the treat was, they're going to be really jealous because they play the drums too.
great.
Have 1 minute, guys. 5 minutes to go.
I thought we could fire the task quite easily because we may have put a bit too much water on so it could have dribbled off. Or we could have just smudged it a bit by accident.
You have now got 3 minutes left.
One. And then the hi-hat and the snare drum. Two. And then there we go again. Three. And then four.
I was very glad that Cheetah was with me. She's a very good artist and a very good face painter.
Do the squats.
You two, you have got 55 seconds left, so I recommend that you start speeding it up now.
Just do squats, everyone!
This is how to rock out properly. Everyone got a drumstick? Yeah. OK, just go for it! Always got to finish with a cymbal.
10 seconds. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pushes down, guys. Joe, please come over here. Because, of course, you'll be judging this.
Right. OK, so we had 6 minutes. I think you rushed it at the beginning slightly, and I can see you've had to kind of reapply some paint there. Mm-hmm. But having said that, one, two, three, four, five.
There's five spots. Joe, stop teasing us. Is it a pass or is it a fail?
I think I'm giving them the thumbs up. I think.
Yeah!
Ronnie, can I just say thank you so much for painting my face earlier on?
No props. I told you look fat.
I know, it looks awesome. Everyone has been stopping me so far, pointing, laughing. It's been brilliant.
You see, and you didn't trust me.
I know. Am I a dog as well?
Not quite. Got to say, they said Jordan was the leader, and I really saw that in the second task yesterday. He was brilliant.
Really? Oh, that's great news, because he didn't really show that in the first task. He was quite quiet.
Well, he obviously learned from his mistakes, because on the second task, he was so vocal, it was brilliant.
Oh, brilliant. That's great news. Who do we think is going to go on and do the final task?
Well, Jordan, I think, is a really great leader, but you know what? I think Cheeto would also like to be the leader.
So a bit of a leadership struggle.
I think so.
Oh, I tell you what, we haven't had a surprise twist for a while.
Ooh, that could get interesting.
Yes, it could, couldn't it? Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Now then, Soph, tell us what you get up to for your second truce.
We went to a drum studio and we had a drum lesson on a real drum kit.
So, were you any good at it? Did you have rhythm?
Basically, it was going completely nuts. You just could hit everything, the cymbals, the drums, the bass drum.
You were hitting everything?
Yes, with sticks.
Nice.
It's very rock and roll.
Well, while you were doing your truce, we, of course, were doing the second task.
So, Morgan, what was that second task?
Our task was to do a face paint. And we had to do it on Jordan.
Cheetah, what was your design?
We had to design them as a spooky dog. And we only had 6 minutes to do it.
Well, what we need to know is, did you pass or fail your second task?
Sorry, guys, but we passed.
You won't fool us.
Well done, guys. They worked really well as a team, but it still means that in the final round, you still need two people to do the last task.
This is where a problem comes about. Which two of you want to volunteer, or do two of you want to get selected by the unlucky dip, or do you want to go for the team option, where all five of you could do it? But remember, if you do take that option, one of you fails, you all fail. Yeah.
Yeah, so, guys, you want a few moments to talk about it?
Right. That's the surprise twist sound.
Here we go. Dear best of friends, in a moment, you'll be passed an envelope. This envelope contains five pieces of paper, only one of which is an L for leader. The person who gets this piece of paper will become the leader of the group and must then choose who will be doing the next task and who will be doing the next treat. Do you understand that, guys?
Yeah.
So in this envelope, I have your five pieces of paper. Only one has the L on. That's right. Let's find out who it's going to be. We'll start with the taskers from the last round. If you'd like to choose one of those red pieces of card.
Ooh.
OK, it's not going to be you.
Save.
Cheetah, you're in next. It's not you, Cheetah. Morgan? It's not you, Morgan. So, girls, one of you is going to be the leader. But which one's it going to be? You're up first, Sophie. Which one are you going for, this side or this side? Oh. So that means, Katie, you are the leader. You're going to have 10 seconds to decide what you want to do, and your time starts now.
Okay then, Katie, what's your final decision?
Well, Judo's going to do it. Mm-hmm. And I think Sophie should do it as well.
Okay then, how are you feeling about that, Soph?
I really do hope that we will pass this so I can get a treat as well.
We will, trust me on that, sister, we will.
Right then, nice bit of bonding going on then. Sisterhood, two girls up for the final task. You three doing the final treat. Hopefully, though, you will all be there together. Mm-hmm.
There is one more thing to do as well, and that is to find out who's coming along with you. So let's bring in the presenter's unlucky dip. OK, there we go.
Yeah.
Today feels good. We've got a sweet, so what do we do?
You suck!
Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Are you ready? Let's find out. One, two, three.
You know, you're going to have a great treat, of course, it is a final treat. You two, you up for the final task?
Yeah.
All right, hope we all pass it and meet the others a bit later on. But in the meantime, should we have a circle of friendship?
Yeah.
Let's do it. Here we go. Bob in for the very last time. One, two, three.
We are the best of friends because we're cool. The important thing is that we run.
Task three. With the help of our foreign language expert, you'll be taught how to count in Polish.
Oh, no, Polish. Oh,
yes, from
Polish.
1 to 20 in 10 minutes. You know Polish.
We don't know to 20. No, we do kind of.
So you already know how to count in Polish. Well, that's actually brilliant then, so this task is achievable. You'll then have 3 minutes 30 to take it in turns to put the numbers which you've been taught in order on our board. You must each put the foreign numbers in the right order or you will fail. Guys, let's go for it. Go on, teach me how then.
Okay, here we go. Okay, this says treaters. For this, your final treat. You're off to Hampshire Cricket Club's Rose Bowl Stadium.
Cool.
You'll be getting a tour of the stadium and you'll meet some of the players for a training session in the cricket nets. How's that? Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Have you played cricket before?
No.
No, you haven't? You've played a little bit before. Let's go meet the professionals. Let's do it. See you there.
Right then, Cheeto and Sophie, we promised you a Polish language expert, and here she is. Hi, Anna.
Hello.
Thank you so much for coming down here today. Please, for everybody at home, are you Polish?
Yes, I am.
Can you count yourself 1 to 20 in Polish?
Of course I can. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Done with such ease. Guys, did you pick all that up?
No.
Nah, I didn't think so. Now, as you can see in front of you, the numbers are actually written down. Anna is now going to have 10 minutes to teach you how to recognise the numbers. Then you'll have 3 minutes 30 seconds, but you'll take it in turns to place the numbers on the board, and you'll have to go 1 down to 20. Have you got that? OK, 10 minutes to teach these girls how to recognise 1 to 20 in Polish. Your time starts now.
OK, so we'll start from number 1 to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
I guess that Katie picked me because Cheeto was going to do the task and Cheeto wanted me to do it with her.
So you remember that number 10 is actually in number 20 as well.
When I found out what the last task was, I was quite happy because I thought this was going to be easy because I'd learned some Polish before at school.
If I mix the order, do you think you can put them in the right order? Good.
Right then, ladies, you've had your 10 minutes, so please turn away, no peeking. Anna, with your help, please let's mix all these up. Let's mix them all up. OK, are we happy with that, Anna? How'd you say your time starts now?
Zacznijcie teraz.
What she just said. Go.
I think me and Sophie were the best girls for the job because I think the others might have struggled a bit.
So you're looking for number 4. There you go. They've got their little technique, haven't they?
Yeah.
Come on, girls, what are you looking for next? What number?
Me and Cheeto worked out a way to remember the numbers and using simple words, and this is what they were. Jam doesn't try cutting pie, silly sausage on dancing duck.
Take your time with this. You have got 2 minutes left.
See.
Remember that final treat. OK, as you've actually got plenty of time here, you're doing extremely well.
D-Z-I-E-S-I-A.
Yeah, that's
right. It's positive.
100%.
Girls, you positive?
Positive. All right, I'm going to stop at the clock. Now, you've still got 15 seconds left on it, but you're saying you're happy. I don't know how well you've done. Anna, that's up to you. Please take a look at the board and then let us know how the girls have done. Fingers crossed for you, though, ladies.
Not sure. Let me have a look. Zadanie zaliczone. Gratulacje.
What does it mean, please? Can you translate that, Anna?
You've passed the task.
Yes! Well done, girls! That means we're going on the final sheet. Anna, thank you so much. How do you say that in Polish?
Dziękuję.
Dziękuję, Anna.
Dziękuję.
Dziękuję, Anna.
Dziękuję, Anna.
Dziękuję.
Dziękuję.
No problem, guys. Come on, let's go and see the others. Well done! Dziękuję, Anna.
OK, kids, here we are in the indoor school at Hampshire Cricket. Quite a big area, as you can see. So what we're going to do now is, first of all, we're going to...
Aha! Oh. Yeah. This is Rani, co-presenter, and these are the other guys that have been doing their task a little bit earlier. Have you got some news for us?
Yes! We passed!
Yeah, they were absolutely awesome on the task. They did it so well. Well done, Katie, for choosing them. But now they deserve a final treat. What are we doing?
Well, we're going to be playing cricket with these guys. We'll play for Hampshire. So get yourselves kitted up. You can take those jackets off for a start because we've got to do a warm-up.
Watch the ball. Eyes on the ball.
Good.
Oh! 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 Shot.
Field it.
I felt really glad telling my friends that I passed the task because I thought the task was going to be very hard.
The treat was when I met the famous cricket players because they taught you how to like do all the proper moves with all the cricket bats and that.
It won't affect our friendship that Katie picked me to do the final task because we'd be best friends forever.
When I was the leader, I felt nervous because I had to pick between my friends, but I'm happy with the decision that I made.
It doesn't matter what happens in our lives, we'll always be there for each other.
I'm really impressed with Cheeto for doing the last task, even though she knew it'll be really, really hard.
I know that we're going to be best of friends because we're all very close and we all really, really like each other.
I'm so happy that Sophie and Cheeto weren't stumped by our final task.
And they got a wicked final treat.
See you next time on Best of Friends. Bye.